What are you doing?
You said if I wanted to buy or sell a house in Central Florida that I should follow you.
On social media!
You got a link?
Buying or selling a home? Visit celebratingflorida.com or follow me on social media. Good
everybody doing? It is a rare Saturday stream. So let me hop out of here because I am in. Get into YouTube really, really fast. Bear with me for just a second. We are here just south of Disney. We're just south of 192. We're about maybe 10 minutes. Probably about 10 minutes from Disney World. We're over in Davenport, and we're in this community. It's a guarded gate community for this home tour, and we're going to go into that home right into there. We're going to have Victor give us a tour. This is in Polk County. This is a 5-bedroom, 4.5-bath, private community townhouse. And I will tell you, driving up, there were schools, there was a Publix, there was restaurants, gas stations. And in this community alone, you've got basketball courts, tennis courts, you've got a lazy river, you've got a pool. Possibly want, it is nice. And right now I'm gonna get out of the road because there's a Tesla coming. So let me get out of the road. And let me say hi to everybody. Let me get into my stream here. There we go. And of course it's gonna give me an ad. I'm gonna just turn that down. So what is up? Mike Wazowski, Waz is in here. We got Nickel in here. Joe is in here. Pierce, Coach N. We got Pierce in here. Hello. Love Pugs. Dave is in here. Danza Daddy, what is going on? I haven't seen you in a forever. Jimmy Tiger's in here. Jaden is in here. What is up, guys? Chad Jackson. Derek Black, what's going on, Derek? Who else we got? Let's see. Let me go. Who we got? You guys are just chatting it up. Shannon is in here. And it's awesome seeing all you guys in here. I'm excited about this because I love touring new houses. So this is going to be pretty cool. All right, so let's go in. And I got to tell you, I was just in there. It is really, really nice in there. So we're going to go in. I've got a fact sheet. So any questions that you guys have, do let me know. This was built in 2021. So this was built a couple years ago. And I can answer any questions you got because I got the fact sheet. And you can also at any point ask Victor any questions that you may have. It's central air. It's for heat. It's central and electric. 5 bedrooms, 4 full baths, 1 half bath. utilities, cable available, cable connected, ceiling fans, solid surface counters, dishwasher, disposal, dryer, range, refrigerator, washer, carpet, and tile. It's got everything. So let's go in. No fireplace. Let's see. But you're in Florida, so. So let's go in. We're going to go right on into this house.
And I've got another streamer here.
And Victor's live as well. What's up, Victor?
How are you?
Where do you get hats like this? I need a hat like that.
Okay. Oh, you guys aren't seeing my hat.
Yeah, you got to show off the hat.
Hey. eBay.
Oh, nice.
eBay. It was eBay. It was terrific. I love it.
I need that.
I love shopping on eBay. There's always so many unique stuff that you'd never consider. So, for those of you, how many people watching actually stay on Disney on property? How many stay on property? I mean, if you stay on property, say you stay on property. If you stay off property, tell me. Because I want to teach you about how to rent a short-term rental, what to look for, what the big things are that you can get, and how to buy one so that you could use it for your vacations. You know, imagine if you come down, you know, four times, people who come down four times a year, twice a year or something like that, and they spend how much a night? Some of the hotels are $400 a
night. Yeah, $400-$500 a night. It's insane what
and
they
how
cost.
Much, how many people can you fit in those rooms?
Oh, yeah, they're tiny.
Yeah. So now you've got five bedrooms. So you can invite grandma, who can babysit for the kids, watch them by the pool, put them to bed. She goes to bed. Right? So you, when you come down, you have privacy. You're not sleeping in the same bed with your kids, right? And the kids get their own bed. When people do this, I always like to go by heads of households. Three heads of households. People who don't usually, three different homes are represented. So you have, you know, a brother, a sister, their kids, their husbands, and grandma. And they're all got this big place. For when you're in town, right? And then you rent it out the rest of the time.
And the really cool thing is that you can get up and make breakfast. You can go to the Publix. Before you go out to the parks.
Now, let me ask you about that. How much does it cost each person for breakfast?
Oh, it's a ton of money.
Yeah, it's like $20.
Yeah.
For each person, I guarantee you, you'll pay for three people having breakfast for the entire week that you stayed here. Just in your own food and stuff like that. Aren't waiting. So, anyway, so this property is available now. It is $580. I happen to know that one just recently closed and they're saying they're recently went under contract and they're saying that it's going to close at $590 and it's in the same community.
Look at that. Look at that light. That is awesome.
To be honest with you, I'm not that crazy about it.
Not that crazy about it?
No, I think they should all be ceiling fans in here.
Oh, yeah, you definitely want a ceiling fan.
Yeah, because you know what? It'll save them money in the long run.
Plus, you're getting hit by sun in the morning here.
Yeah.
So, yeah, you're right. But it's just like, wow, that's something to look at there.
Great question, Alyssa and Neil. Let me tell you where we are. I will put up that slide.
Got the TV mounted here. Look at this. I like how it's decorated. I do like how it's decorated. This is really, really nice. So at any point you guys have any questions, definitely let me know.
Okay, here's where we are. Okay, the start of the
Yeah, it's a gorgeous bedroom. And you've got the closet right here. Look at that. Really nice. Good size closet.
Horizons. They're working on a connection road there.
And how can you have this mudroom already here?
Go straight up, go over. That's almost exactly the way I came in today. Except I had to drive a little bit further up.
Yeah.
So we're 15 minutes from Disney. I got here in 14 minutes, I'd say.
Mm-hmm. And
in Davenport.
Yeah.
Any questions?
Let's see. So far, no questions. Everybody's loving it. Everybody loved the bedroom.
Great. So let's go out. Because you wouldn't expect a house like this to have a pool. Now, I will tell you, if you're an owner, and if anybody wants me to do a class on owning a short-term rental, I can tell you everything you need to know. But you need to have a security fence.
Mm-hmm.
That is, now you can have a security fence, or you can have a lock that's 54 inches off the ground. But I'd rather have a security fence, and I'd rather have both. This has to be up when the guests arrive. And there's enough room by the pool so the guests can lay out. I see that a lot in these homes that people are buying. And for a vacation rental townhome to be able to stretch out by the pool, that's something I usually don't see. I don't see that in the single family homes.
Yep. And what's the square footage here?
Square footage is about 2,200 square feet.
Okay, that's a good size.
Yeah, wait till you see the rest of the stuff they put in here. So you would go out this drive, it's right here, turn right and go to hit 27.
Mm-hmm.
If you turn left, you'd go the back way in, but it's gonna be a really good way to get in shortly. And then here you have a nice outdoor dining table. There is a...
Oh, that's nice.
That's crazy. Okay, and there's a pool bath right here as well.
That
is
very nice.
I do not know how to lock that up. That's crazy. Okay. All right, so here we are. You have a little... Oh, why am I getting...
There's like a little dead spot, like right over here. Not sure why. Because I'm running into it too.
That's weird. I've never run into that. That was a real dead spot.
Yeah.
Okay. So, you get this full kitchen. It's not a kitchenette. You get an actual stove, unlike when you go to, one of the parks and you get like just a microwave.
Yeah.
You know, you got a full stove. You get all the things you need here with your plates and everything. But anyway, when this house is sold, every single thing that's in here is going to be included. Everything here.
Yeah.
So fully furnished. You got to, there's no reason. Now, you may not like the furniture, but at least it gets you started. Because if you're renting, you don't want to waste the first 2-3 months decorating the place. You know? Someone else has already done it for you. Let me close the...
Oh, I'm sorry, but I should have closed that.
Yeah. Were you born in a barn? Okay.
Several, actually.
Past that dead spot. So, full kitchen. You got plenty of eating area here. So, here's the top things that I always like to tell people to look for in a short-term rental. Number one, close to Disney World. This is under 20 minutes. A gated community. This is guard-gated. The first floor bedroom is really important when you're renting because you may get that customer who wants to bring grandma. And grandma doesn't want to go up and down the stairs. So you get a first floor bedroom with a step-in shower. Now, unless you have a one-story house, that's not, that's fine. You have a one-story house, everybody can use all the bedrooms. But I will tell you, this is a key feature to keep 10 to 15% of your bookings. Because you don't want, when they email you and say, hey, do you have a bedroom on the first floor? You don't want to say no. Anytime you say no, that's a potential lost booking. So, and believe me, I know because I learned the hard way. And here is a step-in shower. Does anybody have any questions?
And is there an HOA? There's probably an HOA here.
There's got to be an HOA.
Got to be an HOA, yeah.
This came up with a question from a customer. They wanted a gated community, but they didn't want an HOA. And I said, "There's that does not exist. You might have a low HOA.
Yeah.
Because the lowest HOA I ever saw. Or you may have a, but this has an HOA of $600 a month.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the reason is because it has guard gate, has a lazy river.
Yep.
There is a huge pool. There's tennis courts. There's an arcade. There's all these different things in a restaurant. And even a fireworks viewing area.
Yeah.
So that's pretty nice.
Yeah, that's really cool.
Alyssa and Neil say Grandpa can sleep on the floor. Yeah, Grandpa wasn't invited. I always mention Grandpa. He's an old grump. Anyway, so close to grocery. This one has a grocery store less than a quarter mile up the street. And there's plenty on the way back. You need Wi-Fi and cable TV. You need arcade space in the community center, but if you pay from $200 to $400 a night. Now, I would say I like to take, when I have a rental, I like to take the bookings myself so that I don't have to share the commissions with the rental agency. So when I had my home, I used to do all the bookings myself. Now we're gonna step upstairs. No questions?
That was the last one.
No question. Do they like my hat?
They love your hat.
Okay, good.
And if they didn't love your hat, I'd have to kick them right out.
Yeah, I think that's a yeah. Good, yeah.
Because I don't, just can't.
Oh, now, time to go to Disney at your doorstep if you wanna follow this stream.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
So if you wanna follow Victor, you can go to Disney at your doorstep, or at yourdoorstep.com.
And you can find all my links there. It's a link tree page.
Okay, see, I love this room already.
See, the thing is, a lot of rentals will put their game room in the garage.
Mm-hmm.
It's hot, it's nasty, it's not decorated properly, it's a garage. This place, you could say, game room in the house. And all these will come with it with a full price offer. If not a full price, doesn't come with it.
Oh, you got Frogger in here. Nice. I'm always joking when I'm going against the crowd on Main Street. I'm playing Frogger because I'm in the scooter. And there it is. There's Frogger.
This property is 2 years old. This one's a little bit better light here. It has, let's see, now this is the primary bedroom. So imagine you rented this place. This is as big as I would say some of the rent, the rooms you rent for $400. This is like 13 by 13 or more. Yep, there he is, Brian Boyd. Jeff Smith is saying hello.
Hey, Jeff, how's it going?
I thought you were just my viewer, Jeff. Oh, no, you're cheating on me. Big closet, and this is what we call the owner's closet. They have it. Okay. Oh, this is the air conditioner. Sorry. Okay. Oh, I've got to check that out. I've got to... So, having your own bathroom when you come here to stay in your property. So if you're, you know, thinking of a short-term rental, think about how long you wait for the bathroom when you've got one bathroom for 5-8 people. I'm sorry, what'd you say? You say something, Brian?
Oh, I was going to say, man, I kind of wish I would have done the Wi-Fi. Because there's a few more spots than I thought, but so far we're doing good.
It's right on this thing.
Oh, cool. Okay.
The one that says Spectrum.
Okay. Nice.
Okay, so let's go into... Now, they've got two primary bedrooms, what we used to call masters, owner's suites with attached ensuite baths. And Diane, I think you got my message that this is 2 years old. I like how they've done this. Oh, this is nice. Okay, let's see. Oh, you know, that looked from the distance, that actually looked like it was real wood. Okay. It's just like, you know, I love the accent walls. Because, you know, one thing I say
nice.
When you're having a rental property and you're renting it, it's all about the pictures. If you don't have good pictures, you don't have a good property. You're not going to be able to rent it. So that really helps make the property look. Step in shower. And the management company sets up this, which I think is really neat. That they do something like that. When this happens, this thing goes. Look at that. Why is it doing that?
All right, so here is the bathroom, guys. Paris, I don't think it comes with a kegerator. Come on. Sold separately.
Now, another thing that people are looking for. Arcade space in the house, space to stretch out by the pool, and the other thing that I like in a community, and this is very important, is strong word of mouth advertising. And when you're by a home that's by itself or in a very, very small community, you have less people coming back and saying, oh, we stayed in this community, it was great. You got to stay in this same community. And you get less people, you have less people doing that, you got less chance of picking up some of those residual bookings. And honestly, I wish I knew all this when I started renting myself. My sister and I had five properties, three properties for 2 years. I wish I had known all these things. I wouldn't have bargained.
All right.
Now look at this. This I think is so amazing.
Isn't that room cool?
Now, and this is so
Victor was in here earlier. Look at this. A Harry Potter room. This is awesome. Look at the lamp.
I would say the big TVs aren't really that necessary. But you do need a TV in every room.
That Harry Potter room is amazing.
Then you step in here, shared bath. Tub. Not getting many questions today.
Let's see.
Oh, Lorraine is drinking out of that same Bucky's cup right now.
Oh, yeah. You got to love that Bucky's cup, right? That's like the best cup ever.
So let's go back downstairs and talk some more about... Does anybody have any questions about where you advertise for your short-term rental?
And, you know, having a management company, they manage the pool for you. Yes. So if you were to turn this into a rental property... the management company would take care of the pool for you. They'd just have a guy come in.
Exactly.
Never have to worry about it.
Yeah, they hire, to get your Bucky's cup out of the wood for you. Anyway. Yeah, when you're responsible for the cleaning of the property after person arrives during the thing to you don't really have those, you don't have to deal with the day-to-day issues that you would if you were living here.
Okay, so out of curiosity, am I okay to say that I give out the address?
Yeah.
Okay. We are at
107 Jetty Wy.
Yeah, I'm
that's better.
And if you needed to, there's plenty of places to walk your pets.
If you bring a pet.
Yeah, if you bring a pet, there's plenty of places.
When you're renting it out, you want to specify to the management company if you will be pet friendly. And then that comes with like an extra fee, and they'll come in and they'll cover the furniture so the pets don't ruin it. They'll also require that the pet is in a cage when you're not here.
Yeah.
So I don't know how many people want to keep their pets in a cage. To be honest with you, I would put it in a bathroom.
Yeah.
And then at least if it makes a mess, you know, you could easily clean it up. It's not on fabric. And, the pet will be, they're alive. What do you want? Okay. So does it come fully furnished? Yes. This property is being sold. Everything that you see here. Everything you see here is included, including the dishware, which, by the way, I don't recommend. There's one, they got glasses in here, and I don't never have glasses in your property. I don't know how many times I have to tell people that. Okay. Okay, I think VRBO is, Lorraine, is the best in the business. If you could develop your business based on social media and things like that, yes, I think it's terrific. But I would always direct them back to your VRBO page, because it's a great way to take bookings. It's a great way to interact with your customers. But VRBO is really the best in the business. Airbnb, while it is very good, I think this... I think it's got a stigma to it that you think somebody's going to be in the house too. You know, people think they're renting a room from someone, which some of them do, but it's got that stigma to it. That's not bad, but it's just, I don't think it helps the people who don't have, the property or renting the property all to itself. So David, he loves Disney. What could this rent for nightly? This would rent for $200 to $400 a night, okay? But I would strongly suggest that you don't want to rent it for less than 6 days, okay? And if you rent it for 6 days, make sure you are in touch with your insurance company and find out, because my insurance company changed the policy on me and said, it's got to be only 7 day rentals, and 7 days or to 30 days. And that was a nightmare because I had to go back and change everybody's reservation.
Yeah. And what's cool is I had some friends of ours that owned a home that they had managed in on Padre Island in Texas, which is a vacation destination.
Mm-hmm.
And what they would do is they would kind of block out some time that they wanted to go. And they used that, so they always had a place to stay. And for the rest of the year, just rent it out, and it would cover the mortgage on the property. So it's a great investment property, and you can come here and save so much because you're already putting money into this property. And it's a great way to, you know, be able to come down and enjoy that.
Yeah, Lorraine is saying 200 to 400, betting on the season.
Yeah.
So in the summertime, I would say this could be $400 a night because we book in, you know. And one thing about this that's interesting, yes, I'm wearing a silly hat. one thing that's interesting about this, about Central Florida, is you could book 48 weeks out of the year probably if you've got an appealing home. While if you owned in Miami, that's not true. If you owned where I used to go to the shore when I was a kid, Wildwood, New Jersey, you get 10 weeks and rent the other times of the year. Here, you can rent. I used to rent 48 weeks out of the year,
mm-hmm.
You know. So, yeah. Shireen Victoria Turnbull is asking, is this property? Yes. Okay. One of the biggest things I got and regrets that I had when I had my short-term rental, I didn't realize this, is that people do ask to be in a gated community. Now, I don't like to say gated community. I like to say in the intro, you'll be greeted at the gate by an attendant,
mm-hmm.
who will direct you to your unit. And then they give you a pass for the rest of your stay. I don't like to say gated community, but you know, it's guard gated is the worst. Guard gated is terrible. People think, well, why do I need that? You know, it's either you get the ones who want it or the ones who are going, why do I need that? No, you want it because it's an extra piece of security.
Mm-hmm.
The fees are $600 a month for that. But I want you to remember all the community features this place has. Okay. It's got a clubhouse, a fitness center. It's gated. There's a big pool. There's a lazy river. There's tennis courts. It also includes the 24-hour guard, cable TV, internet. Anyway, pest control and private roads. So that is a lot of stuff that you're paying in there that you're not. When I had my rental, I used to have to pay for cable TV. And that's, you know. Where did I get this cute hat? I can't wait to go to the parks when it's cold and wear it. But I got it on eBay. It's from Tokyo Disney Resorts. So they get the greatest stuff.
They have the coolest stuff. Popcorn buckets, hats.
They do. They have the greatest stuff. I think I should wear this all over. Oh, $600 per month. Yes, it's six. Honestly, when you look at how much you're getting and how much the other communities charge for similar features. Also, on a townhome, you're going to have the exterior maintenance and the roof. So that's a big thing.
So one thing David D. broke down in our chat, and I kind of want you to look that over and just see what you think. If that's the case, that's an incredible amount of profit right there.
He's saying the same thing on here.
Oh, he is? Okay. Because if that's the case, that's amazing.
Well, you got to remember, one of the things is I like when people look at the minimum they could make and the maximum. Don't count on the maximum.
Yeah.
Because honestly, you never know. Like my sister, well, anyway, long story with that. But I did well. I did really well.
Yeah.
Anyway, I had a lot of equity in that, but it was fun. It was fun. I was too, you know what my problem was? I was too hands-on.
Mm-hmm.
And I was living here, and someone called and said they couldn't get in. You know, I would rush down. I don't have to, you know. I was like, no, that's what the management company is for. And it's usually a user error.
Yeah.
You know. So, we got about 20 more minutes. Let's see what else I have here for questions and things. These are top things to remember when buying a vacation home. Okay. The one of the things is I find a lot of people will say you've got to know the territory. Okay. For example, I have a customer that I'm dealing with right now that wants to rent something short term. And they said, oh, we love these three houses. And each one of them were not in short-term rental communities. And I said, first of all, you tell me you're going to rent it as short-term. I can't sell that to you because if you do rent it short-term, you're going to get fined every single day. And don't think they're not going to find out.
Oh, yeah.
Especially if it's gated.
Now, real quickly, to answer Pierce's question.
Oh, great.
Pierce, there is a lot of places, for nightlife on 192. There's a lot of good places.
Yeah.
I mean, they just opened up a Portillo's on 192.
Oh, my God, I can't wait to go there.
Oh, God, I love that place.
Yeah, it's like the diet. You know?
And so there's a lot of good places. If you want to be outside the bubble and you kind of want to enjoy a little bit of a nightlife, 192's got a lot of places like right over here. And there's a lot of great restaurants, bars, stuff like that if you just want to go hang out. It's a great, great area.
Yeah. I'm going to show pictures of the community center in a second, Diane. I really don't, nobody likes cameras in their face when they're paying for a vacation. So, you know, I don't want to go in, but it is the best community center that I have seen. But let me go through a couple more of these things that you should remember. Okay, so you got to know if they allow short-term rental. I've seen this happen. One realtor told me, oh my God, I didn't realize they didn't allow short-term rental. I'm like, how do you not realize that? It's in the HOA documents.
Mm-hmm.
I take the document, I circle it, and I say initial year so you know whether you want to rent or not. You got to know.
Yeah.
That was, and that happened early on in my career that I heard about that. And I was like, oh my gosh, that is a life lesson. Another thing I want you to realize that is if you are coming into town Thanksgiving and you want to look at short-term rentals to buy that are renting right now, let me tell you, they're going to be booked because if they're not booked, there's a problem with that house because that is the most popular time. So come during a time that's not popular, like May or September, or definitely on a Saturday so that there's at least a transition of people coming in and out. I have shown so many houses where the cleaning crew is in there. So that's one of the things you're always going to hear, and I hear it all the time, well, if they want to sell it, why do they have guests in there? Because they want their cake and eat it too. Mm-hmm. If you're getting money coming in, are you going to, they don't realize you can't sell it if people aren't seeing it. Now, what happened to me this week is this property is booked starting Sunday and I have someone who wants to see it on Tuesday. So what I said is walk by the property, but the neighbor is available. They're vacant and they're empty and they're $30,000 less. We've got $70,000 worth of furnishings in here. Go look at them. You may like that.
Mm-hmm.
You may be $70,000.
Call him a gentleman in our chat, and David D posted all the information in chat to get a hold of Victor.
Mm-hmm.
So definitely do that, and Victor can maybe help you out. You know,
absolutely. What I would go to Disney at Your Doorstep email right there and make it neutral colors, and it should sell. Thank you. Features around here. Look at this. This is the community river. It's got a huge pool. It's got a tennis court. It's got at the lower, the community center has a gym. Obviously, if it's got a gym, there's people working out. They don't want cameras on them. So I just, otherwise I'll get thrown out. They have a restaurant, the Blue Marlin restaurant in there. The great thing about that is imagine if you are using the property and your kids want something to do. And if you're in a community that's only got, you know, and you've only got the pool, kids are going to get bored with that and they're going to want to go to the parks.
Mm-hmm.
But if you want to stay in and your renters want to stay in, or grandma wants to take the kids to the pool one day while you, you know, recuperate from yesterday at the parks. So that's a, you know, that is, it's a great way to have great features to have, and people are looking for these type of features.
So Dave, we are at 107 Jetty in Davenport, and we are about 15 minutes south of Disney. Mm-hmm. And we're kind of like, we are near Highway 27 and 192.
Yeah. It took me from my house, and I'm an extra 3 minutes. It took me 18 minutes to get here. And I was really surprised. I was like, so I was hanging out for a while. So look at this. This is the type of pool they have.
Look at that fire pit. That is nice.
That I think is actually the viewing area for the fireworks. And of course the hot tub and hammocks for crying out loud.
I need that.
Yeah.
Hey, that there I am.
Yeah. Love the hat. Okay, so let's talk a little bit more about what type of things when you're buying short and why this is such an excellent community to be in. Okay. One of the things I always tell people is get an area that you like as well, because a lot of people buy these things without really considering, you know, they think, well, you know, my people will like it. No, if you don't like it, they won't like it. And it's surprising to me that I will see people, I don't like that part of town, but, you know, it should be a good rental. No, it won't, because you don't like it. You're not going to be able to rent it with enthusiasm. And you'll be surprised how many people will do that.
Yep. Dave, that's part of the community center that's on the property.
Yeah.
This is a townhome. And in the community, they have their community center. And all of that is there. There's a lazy river. What else is over there? You've got a didn't you say there was a restaurant over there as well?
Tennis courts, a restaurant, a gym.
Yeah.
Arcade. Community with almost 1,000 homes. And I always say you want to get a bigger community so you take advantage of all the features that are shared by all the other people here. Because most of these people are going to Disney during the day.
Mm-hmm.
Most of them. The rest, you know, who don't, you know. But it's very funny how you've got to be 10, 15, 20 minutes from Disney.
Yeah.
If you're going to rent a short-term rental. And when the road gets through here that's going to connect, you're going to be an easy 15 minutes you're there. Because right now you have to go up and around a little and stuff like that. But I hate to say this because I don't want to put someone down, but I had a customer who bought a house in Winter Haven and allowed short-term rental. And I said, this is absolutely too far away. And I said, go online. Look at their booking schedules. They're in foreclosures. And I said, I hate to say this. I said, I really don't think you're listening to me.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, we're done. I'm never was And, it, you know, I mean, I'm like, you've got to be close to Disney.
And from that area.
Do you understand what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Oh, you do? Okay, great. I'll sell you that.
Yeah.
It becomes, you know, you just, sometimes they just don't want to understand that people are not going to travel 40 minutes to Disney.
Yeah.
And especially the south part of 27, it's pretty high traffic.
Yeah.
It's pretty high traffic.
And yeah, there's a lot of traffic that way. You know, if you were going to just do Ubers, you're going to add to the fare just by being that far away. It's not close at all.
Yeah. Drew is asking if this community is only short-term rentals. Actually, this is one of the very few that is only short-term rental. Basically, they say you cannot become a permanent resident here. And in your HOA docs, it'll show you that you can't. But there's nothing to stop you, really, except you can never homestead the property, which means, say, it's your permanent residence. This is not the kind of place that I would say, unless you really want $600 HOA fees and all those features. But what a lot of people do is they'll spend, and there's nothing to stop you with that, is to spend, you know, come down here as snowbirds, and then the rest of the year, because we can rent all year round. Because we can rent all year round. It's keeping me warm too. They rent the rest of the year. Nothing to stop you from doing that. So let's see if we can go outside, because we did get a request to go outside, and I'll see what I can show you of the community center. If you need to reach me, go to disneyatyourdoorstep.com. Bingo. Okay, there we are. So, and on the description of this video is a link to learn more about this property. And for the person who's saying they want to sell, mm-hmm. This is one of the things I do, which is live streams from the property.
Mm-hmm.
What's good about that is if they can't get down right away, I can say, here, go look at this video.
And follow him, follow Victor on social media. Just don't follow him.
My ad. I love that ad.
It's one of my favorites.
Isn't that cute? I love it. Wait till you see the next one I'm doing. Okay, I hope we have a good signal here. But this is one of the key selling points. Don't lock it too much, because I don't have the code with me. I pull it up on the phone. Okay, that's the community center right there. Now, there's another unit available here, and it's about 6 blocks away. So this is right across from the community center. You could only get one house closer.
Yeah.
That's it. It's right there. There's the tennis courts. I think we have a good signal. Is everybody seeing a good signal? Everybody got a good signal? Close this. Do you think it will lock on that?
I don't think so.
Yeah. Let's see if we can go.
Yeah.
Let's see if we got a good signal. Let's ask them. All we can do is ask. I'm telling you, it is so cold today. How cold is it?
Oh, it is freezing. All the lizards are dropping from the trees.
Gosh, yeah. I do want an iguana to drop from the tree. Oh, wait, here we go.
Have a little bit of an issue with
setting general. Okay, I have to go to settings, Wi-Fi off. I hope this works. Okay, can everybody see me? Am I back? Oh. Yeah, this is why I... Okay, I hope I'm back. Yeah, it, you know, I was on Wi-Fi and now I've gone to the phone system. I probably should have done phone all the time through because I have, you know, the 5G, which has been really good lately.
And right there, you can see the restaurant right there, the Blue Marlin Grill.
Blue Marlin Grill right there. Can everybody see me, talk to me, hear me, just say hi. Great, love you. LJ, you always come through for me. So, Blue Marlin Grill right here, your own restaurant. Tennis courts.
Look at that.
That's cute.
We're following the hidden Mickey into the community center.
So we're going to take a look. You know, outside
this. Oh, it smells good in here too. Wow. In.
You know what? Probably lucky today because it's so cold. Nobody's going to be in the pool.
In room massage.
In room massage.
What?
Oh, we got that. You just invite me over.
Look at that. Look at this. You can come in here and get a soda. Get chips, candy bars. Look at this. Look at the shades right here. You got brownies and bunny. I feel like I'm at Disney. You got all your grab and goes, you got your fruit and cup. Get you some goggles and some towels. And look at that pool. By the way, this is a bar. Look at that. I'd be there today, but fast forward to July. And then there's the grill right there. That is amazing.
When you're is it a gated community? No, it's not, but we never, you're not gonna get that booking. So it's better to pay a little bit more and get those features than pay a little less and not get the bookings. But this has every single thing that people are looking for. And I know because I did it for 5 years. Ooh, this is beautiful. Look at this course.
Isn't that gorgeous? Look at it, just sparkles. I don't know if that's showing up
on
the screen.
I'm sure it's the same company that made mine. But it's got blue in it, but mine has
the wall paper there.
Okay, so
yeah, they got a game room right there. They got a weight room.
And then there's a weight room back there, but again there's people using.
Now we probably, since there's nobody at the pool, you think they'd be cool with this or no? Let's see what happens.
If this was the summer, this would be packed. But it's what I like is it's a very flexible pool. You got places you can swim straight out. You've got zero entry over here. You got little water park features up there, nice water park features. The big bucket, for some reason, the big bucket of water just isn't splashing right now. I don't know why. Why do you think that is? I think that is because it's 45 degrees today. Maybe could that's
be.
It.
Could be.
Journey's getting all my ad revenue now.
What?
Journey's getting all my ad revenue
oh,
now.
Oh, gosh.
But I like that. You want to walk over by where the restaurant is?
We can look at it,
yeah. Yeah, why not? I'm already this far in with Journey. May as well.
So they take your money when they're...
Yeah, the second it's played. 10 seconds, I think is what it is.
Because you have a music play.
Yeah.
But right that way, I know it's difficult to see, but from these hammocks and everything, that's where the fireworks are from Disney.
Wow. So you're watching Disney fireworks from right here.
Yeah. Right there.
That's amazing.
There's so you've got a area right out there. Like, can I see if restrooms and all that, yada, yada.
We're doing s'mores tonight. Look at that.
What?
So we're doing s'mores tonight. I'd probably be too old to do s'mores tonight. Yeah. Better be a hot fire.
Oh, no, there's people by the pool.
Oh, yeah, we don't want to do that. But you got the volleyball over there. Yeah, we didn't want to go too far because there is people in the hot tub. Which is where I'd be.
Just rent here and stay in this community. It's called Windsor Island. And just go to VRBO, type in Windsor Island, and there you'll find it. And this corner over there. Volleyball.
Yeah.
Court, right there. I hope we can go out. Yay.
Nice. We escaped.
Oh, good. Okay. But I love it. It's elevated here. I don't know if you can see, but it's elevated here so you can see the fireworks. Most places, you know, around here, you can't really see the fireworks.
That looks like Epcot to me. That is Epcot.
That's Epcot right there.
All right, so
Epcot, so that would mean that way is, so Magic Kingdom's right there.
So right there, I mean, that's as far as I can zoom.
Yeah.
But that's
you
Epcot.
Can zoom? Wow, I can zoom.
Look at that. There's Epcot right there. So that's all Disney World right there. Look at Epcot. I did not think I was going to be able to stand here and see Epcot. So no matter what, you're going to see the fireworks shows at Epcot. And I guarantee you're going to see Magic Kingdom from here.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Oh, yeah. You can see Magic Kingdom. You definitely can see it.
Yeah.
I've got some pictures where you see the fireworks like that big.
Oh, yeah. That'd be awesome.
Yeah. Well, better at my house, but I'm not.
You can hear the train from your house. When you played that video and put it on Facebook, I was like, what?
Oh, yeah, I hear the train, and I hear the Liberty Bell.
That is awesome.
I love that. Oh, my God. And the fireworks in the backyard are just, I mean, sometimes it's a little bit too loud.
Yeah.
But if you've got an older home with single-pane windows, close as I am, oh my God, it's too loud. But
straight ahead.
So just remember, one of the things is that the HOA fees include the painting of the property and the maintenance of the roof.
Yeah, this is really nice.
You don't have to pay any money to use it. It's actually a business expense 2 weeks of the year
Yeah.
Talk to your tax advisor first.
And all your the money you're going to save on not staying at a Disney resort.
What's the VRBO name again for this rental? I don't know. Honestly, I don't know. We're not interested in renting. We are interested. And one thing in this market, there's some changes going around with insurance. So what I would suggest is getting a house that's newer until they work out getting insurance. On anything that's older than 15 years, it's a little difficult to get insurance. So this house is gonna come fully furnished. It's got a large, what we call splash pool. So it's not a swimming pool. 5 minutes ago, I mentioned a VRBO name. Do you remember what I was talking about?
No.
Didn't mention this house.
Yeah, maybe another.
Did I? I don't remember what I, about what I would say. I don't think I mentioned.
Oh, there you go.
Search Windsor Island.
That makes sense.
And that will be where you'd find other properties.
Now that makes sense.
In this community. Yes. Okay. I had to think. So they've got a state-of-the-art fitness center and a game room. I wish I could have showed you, but it's cold, so there's a lot of people in there.
Hello, Chef Ricky.
I'm reading something. I gotta change it. I hate when I have typos and I find them myself. Anyway, so you've got 5 bedrooms. You've got the lower maintenance because it's a. That is a very good question, David. The main reason that they gave me is they don't have. They really did buy it so that they would come here and use it, and they just haven't had more than one chance to come. So that's what they're really telling me is the one of the main reasons that they're selling is they just don't have the time to get here. So you know, so what makes this so perfect is that with the first, when I used to have a rental property, the first questions I would get was, is it a gated community? Is there a first floor bedroom? Is there a pool? They all have to have a pool, a big selling point. We're at an hour, so we're going to only go, anyway. Now, next week, I'll be back to, I'm hoping I'm going to be in Winter Garden next week, next Sunday. And that'll be fun. There's a lot coming up, homes. There's a new construction home in community in Mineola, which I'm happy about. I love Mineola. Mineola, you get better price points. And it's not too far from Disney. Twice a month, it's all right. And then there's some stuff in Claremont that's coming up. I was in Groveland last week, that was a good for me before I sign off, me or Brian. And Brian, you got any questions?
No, this has been a lot of fun. I love doing this, so this is really, really cool. And I appreciate everybody coming in and watching. I apologize, this one spot, well, it's like...
Just stop walking in it then.
I know, but it's like the best spot to get you. But... It'll go away.
Yeah.
The signal. So I apologize to my group if it's been laggy. Does Victor do apartments?
I don't do. Okay. All right. I will gladly talk to you about the areas and everything like that.
Mm-hmm.
I will point you to, and I've done it several times where the people end up, you know, renting. What I'm finding is when I call a listing agent for a rental and I say, I'm an agent and I've got someone. If they've got someone who they're going to get the full commission from, they don't call me back.
Yeah.
So what I do with that is I say, here's Bob's phone number. I like this community. I've been in it. Call him directly.
Mm-hmm.
Because if I call him and you call him, they'll call you the renter first.
Yeah.
Because they want the right. It's not the way you're supposed to do. It's not the way you're supposed to do it when you're selling a home, but when you're renting, whatever. You know, so what I do, so I'll just talk to you about it and tell you what's a good price point, if that's a good area, you know, and I know most of the communities around here, so I would be glad to do that for you. Also, you know what, a lot of times they only offer like, I'll spend my whole day with you and they'll offer me $50 as a commission. I'm sorry. I think that's an insult and I think that's an insult to everybody and then they still don't answer the call to give me the $50.
Yeah.
So anyway, so I know that's horrible to say. I'm not in it totally for the money, but everybody has a job, and you know my broker doesn't like me to do it, so I don't do it. But I will gladly answer any questions about properties or areas or how much you should suspect in rent. You know, I have one person that's looking right now, and she's highlighting. I'll just send you directly to the agent. Why not? You know? Anyway, so.
Yeah.
That's my long answer to do.
Oh, yeah.
When are you going?
Well, I was there I was there yesterday.
Oh.
Loved it. It was
Lorraine,
amazing.
You missed it.
But it's an amazing festival, and I may do. Okay, I don't want to get
Call
you guys excited.
I'll go with you.
But
I want to go there, and I want to buy some art.
I can do all week next week.
Oh, okay. Just call me. I'll do something.
We always got to get Magic Kingdom in there. But I may do two festivals with Magic Kingdom in the middle.
Okay.
So, yeah, we'll definitely go back next week. No doubt about it.
Call me. I'll do it. Looks like it could collect dust. He's saying that it looks like it's difficult to clean. I will tell you. That is a very good point. And in a short-term rental, that is not a good choice.
Yeah.
Because, you know, when people see dust on stuff, they think, you know, the cleaners can do so much,
mm-hmm.
just so much, that they wouldn't get to that until a spring cleaning. So.
Yeah, because
they don't clean by the pool.
And, you know, they're probably...
They can see a whole bunch of garbage out there and they would leave it because they don't clean by the pool.
Yeah.
The pool cleaners will come and take that out, but who knows? So, here's my top 10 features renters are looking for. I'm... horrible I am. And I always say you've got... possible. Okay. Okay, so you gotta be, the number one thing is, the question that you get, and so I think you have to be north of the four, I would say, because we're north of the four, and not past, well, maybe no more than 2 miles past east gated community like this has is the second thing they'll ask for, because they'll ask how safe is the community.
This looked like it was really nice and safe.
Yeah, because, well, here's something that makes this community stand. There's only one entrance.
Oh, yeah, that's good. You don't want multiple entrances. You know?
Yeah, because when you have multiple entrances, people sneak in and go and use the pool.
Yeah.
And, you know, and they're kids and they're having fun and stuff like that, but they increase. You have to have people, you know, ushering them out. And that's not never fun.
Yeah.
One entrance is very, very important. You know, they'll go back, they'll go over to the other communities that have two or three entrances. Very important to keep that down. The first floor bedroom is very important. The close to a grocery. You're going to see about two groceries. Walmart. They want Walmarts. I don't know why, but there's a Walmart right up the street, not too far from here. And right up that way, too. This place has more parking than any other community that I've seen. And the important thing is earlier households, you know, come in and that means three cars sometimes too. South facing pool. This one doesn't have a south facing pool, but you know, I always think that's a very good thing. Arcade space in the home or in the community center. You want something that's going to entertain the kids. This one does come with all those arcade things with the full price offer. Space by the pool to stretch out. And the last thing is strong word of mouth advertising. One of the issues I find when people buy houses that are not in named communities, so they have to go by, like, you know, they're on VRBO, but they're just Davenport or Kissimmee, is people aren't looking for that community. So there's no community there. So they don't know how, it's just going to not show up. So you'd have to go overboard in what kind of features you have. Like there is one house in Montverde that must have put $200,000 just in their features in their home, and the features are like there's a slide and there's a ball pit, all these things that can't be cleaned.
Mm-hmm.
You're gonna get some little kid in a diaper to poop in that ball pit, and it's not gonna be found for months later. I'm telling you, I wouldn't go to that place for anything, because it would cost you $2,000 to clean the whole place every time.
Yep.
You know, but what I'm saying is you want the strong word of mouth advertising. So someone's going to come here to this community, maybe stay across the street, and they're going to love it. It's that house is great. But when their friend is coming to rent and 159 is not available, they're going to say, well, go to Windsor Island and rent something else. You'll love it. And they look through all the. And they approach you and say, I've seen this where they go, the house I wanted is not available, but yours looks even better.
Mm-hmm.
Bingo. Especially when it's. And not all the way across the community. So, just some things that I think you should, you know.
You're talking about the Babe Ruth bar.
Yeah. Yeah.
And.
But it's true that I've seen hard. Thing that's going to create one of the things that's very important when the kids saw that room or else made a mistake of showing the place. I actually had people change their their plans, their travel plans, because they wanted my house.
I'm so sorry. So, I don't know. And then I'll have Victor. You guys can get a hold of him.
Yeah.
And as I'm talking, I'm still in the dead zone. So, with connection out here, I'm pretty sure I do. Oh, okay. Yeah, we can do that.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm gonna do one last show. Mm-hmm. And if you have any questions about decorating, I know everything about decorating for short-term rentals. So here they have their marble room. And think about it. This is not that much money. You get a mural. You get a couple of bed sheets, you're done. And a couple of, you're buying an end table anyway, just make it match the motif.
Okay. Yes, we got that marble room that Victor was just showing. So, quick view of the marble room, which was amazing.
I always say you don't need a big TV, but big TVs are so cheap now, you might as well get them. As long as it has a TV. Look what they did up to the top. Look at that. Isn't that cute? You have any questions about owning a short-term rental? The games are included if... Games are included with the full price offer. And here is the primary bedroom. I'm just gonna take my shoes off and I forgot.
Yeah, I was just thinking that as I was coming up the stairs.
Yeah.
And this would be the master suite here. There's your closet. Room.
Email address, my YouTube channel, or my Facebook page, you're watching on one or the other. And you can ask questions there. You can follow me, Disney@yourdoorstep.com. Oh, I'll leave one light on up here. Oh, here's something I think is great. When you have a short-term rental, label your darn switches. So important, so people aren't going, what's this for? What's that? Wait, what's that? And the lights are all flashing outside. They think there's a short.
Yep.
But yeah, definitely great idea to label your switches. And I have a terrific label maker. I will throw that in as part of the package. Not the label maker, the labels. I will label your stuff. Just give me.
Oh, that's cool. You'll label them? That's awesome.
For you. So, this is the house.
All right.
If you have any house, this townhouse is that you could see the pool area and the kitchen. And I think any
And, you know, we haven't talked about it, but the lighting, the entertainment center, changes colors. I think that's kind of cool.
Yeah. Love and attention. And I'll tell you, it could take you, it could take months done for you. And another thing that I think is really
beautiful table.
Easy to clean. You want something easy clean. You do not want to put a tablecloth out because the cleaners will not clean the tablecloth. But What was I talking about? Cleaning the house. Oh, forget it. Sorry. I knew I was going to mention talk about something. Darn it, it was a...
And guys, I apologize. That spot right there, lag was an issue. So I'm going to just stand over here.
Yeah. So anybody on your switch thing has a question or anything? I think people are hearing me. I'm not seeing anything coming up. Well, visit DisneyAtYourDoorstep.com for DisneyAtYourDoorstep.com. You'll find all my links, Facebook, YouTube. You can please like, share, comment, go to DisneyAtYourDoorstep.com to stay in touch with me. Okay?
And thank you guys so much. And we've got links for Victor under our description. So everything's right there, both of his websites. And check him out on Sundays. He goes live at
not this
all...
Sunday, but next Sunday I'll be live again.
Okay. So definitely is, you know, follow him on Facebook. And because he does live streams from his listings. And I think that is amazing.
But, yeah. From my listings and from new construction.
Mm-hmm.
Every 2 months or so, I go to not mine. Actually, it's been
good.
That gentleman who was interested in.
Thank you so much for coming in and watching. And.
Offer only. It's not cash offer only. One thing to remember on a short term, not appraise, but we have to look at, you know, what the sales prices are without the furniture. So the price is the price, but you're not paying. So say this is $580. Well, we've had appraisal comes in short. You're going, we have price out. It's only been on the market 4 days. Everything. This is the furnishings in this house and decor cost $70,000 and it's all in great shape.
So, Dave, to answer your question,
Melanie Yeager is saying she watches you all the time.
Oh, thank you so much. I appreciate that so much. And and we'll be back on Monday. I'm not sure where, either Magic Kingdom or Epcot.
Well, if you go to Epcot, I may go with you because, I want to go out. I want to go there, and I want to look at the.
Yeah.
And Selena, let me tell you something. Before you talk to me, talk to a lender, because here's the reason why. It's like going into a restaurant and not knowing if you have your credit card or not. You want to make sure you have your credit card. You want to make sure there's some money in your pocket, so you're not. Waste your time looking at the menu, sitting down, eating the bread, having the water, and going, oh, crap, I can't pay for this. I got to go. So check out with your lender so you know your parameters. That's the way you save money, by knowing how much you have to spend.
So Dave had a great question. If somebody rented one of these, would they have access to all amenities? You should. Absolutely.
Yes. Unlike some other communities where... If the owner, and I just sold one recently, but the owner is not going to use the other amenities, and there are some communities that have tiers of amenities.
Yeah.
This one does not. This is you buy it, you got everything. Yeah. And I actually think even though it's $600, it's very reasonable for what's included. And I've seen higher ones, and you know, you got your exterior maintenance, you've got your cable TV, you've got the gate, you got the community center.
Which was really nice. A lot of cool amenities over there. I mean, it was really, really nice. I mean, all the different things that you have available to you, just amazing. Mm-hmm. All right.
Anybody have any last questions before I sign off? I went a half hour longer than I thought I would.
And as it turns out, I should have been standing right here because I got good connection right here. Knock on wood.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you so much for watching today. I'm going to sign off. Remember, I'll be back next Sunday. I try to do it every Sunday unless I get something special on Saturday. And I was going to do something on Sunday, but the place that I was going to go hasn't decorated their units yet. So I'm not doing it. They got to be decorated. I'm not going. Anyway, so.
Julie, Victor can recommend apartments around Disney, but generally he does new construction and
resales. Yeah. Buying. Prices have gone up, but now they're as much as a mortgage payment.
Yeah, it's especially around Disney. They're expensive.
Yeah. I cannot say I think it's going to level off. I really do hope that it levels off.
Yeah.
Because if they're not getting people paying the prices, they're not going to be able to rent them. And if they go 2 months without getting a renter, they're going to have to reduce the price. So I'm hoping that for people's sake, the prices start to level off. I really do. Even for rent and for homes.
Yeah.
So.
I agree.
Yeah.
All right.
All right. Okay. Thank you so much for watching today. I'll be back next time.
This beautiful view right out here. Thank you guys so much. And Victor and I will do this again. This was a lot of fun. You guys have a great time, and I will see you Monday. Thanks a lot, guys.
What are you doing?
You said if I wanted to buy or sell a house in Central Florida that I should follow you.
On social media!
You got a link?
Buying or selling a home? Visit CelebratingFlorida.com or follow me on social media.